We've all experienced the ups and downs of exam season. Here are just a few ways that our mind and body respond to this stressful time. As you may have guessed, your stress levels increase. Now let's explore the mechanism behind this. The body's hypothalamic pituitary adrenal cortical, or HPA, axis stimulates the release of the hormones cortisol and adrenaline. These hormones initiate our body's fight or flight response, which is our evolutionary reaction to stress. You can think of the fight or flight response as our body preparing itself for a perceived threat to survival. Our muscles tighten, our digestion stops, and our pupils dilate. This response is governed by the sympathetic nervous system, which is a pretty sensitive soul. As our stress increases, our pulse rate, blood pressure, auditory reaction times, and visual reaction times all increase accordingly. This is because our bodies are on a hyper alert, ready to deal with a perceived threat to our survival, as we talked about earlier. In this case, the threat is in the looming exam. The fun doesn't stop there. Your liver produces extra glucose to give you a boost of energy in response to stress. The extra glucose provides our body with readily available energy, which is one of the ways we fuel ourselves to deal with danger or perceived demands on our capabilities. Our nerve cells, also known as neurons, contain little tree-like structures at the end called dendrites. Dendrites are the first part of the neuron to receive a nerve impulse. Short-term stress can cause the dendrites of neurons in the brain to rapidly disintegrate, and this reduces our ability to efficiently collect and store memories. Essential proteins and lipids in your body can undergo oxidative damage as a result of stress. And this is bad news for the body, as it can set off a chain of free radical damage to our cells, which can prevent optimal function and initiate the potential for disease. Just when you thought your exam was enough to worry about. You may have previously been the unlucky recipient of a cold mid-exam season. This could be because the number of white blood cells and immune regulatory cytokines in your blood reduce in response to stress, which in turn reduces your body's ability to fight infection. Cytokines are small proteins involved in cell-to-cell communication. Their most important roles revolve around inflammation and immunity. Without them, there is a potential for things to go a little awry. Stress can also encourage disordered eating patterns to emerge. Some people overeat as a result of stress, whilst others may undereat. Stress causes comfort food cravings, which more often than not steers us towards a higher sugar and junk food consumption. Unless, of course, you're the type to crave carrot sticks. This one isn't technically a bodily response, but it is worth noting. Some research has found a negative relationship between cramming and final course grades. It's thought that students who cram prior to exams tend to perform at a lower level in the class. Well, our advice is to start scouring our material here at Kenhub well in advance. And just when you thought you could take a nap and get away with it all, exam-induced stress has been found to cause a reduction in sleep quality too. This may negatively affect exam outcomes. But don't worry, with great planning and dedication, we know you can rule whatever your exam has in store for you. Now over to you, how do you feel before an exam? Tell us on the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and visit our main website kenhub.com for all the material you need to learn anatomy and histology. I'll see you on the next video.